Our thesis entitled Preterintent CNN as feature extractor towards improved malaria parasite detection in the blood semen images, which requires couple of steps to complete. Practical section as follows. We have run our code on Google Colab. We have uploaded 27,000 images where each folder has equal quantity of images. While pre-processing the dataset, we splitted our entire dataset into three subsets, 60% for training, 10% for validation, and resulting 30% for testing. As image dimension can vary depending on the human and test method, we applied parallel processing to speed up image read operation. We resized image as 125x125x3. After level encoding and pre-processing steps, we move on to several deep learning models to compare their performance on validation data. Basic CNN model on CNN from scratch, where CNN model has three convolution and pooling layers followed by two dense layer and dropout for regularization. After training this model, we get a validation accuracy of 95% and it looks to be overfitted slightly looking at our training accuracy, which is 99.9%. For clear perspective on this, we plot the training and validation accuracy and loss curves. Now, instead of training a deep network from scratch, we can take a network trained on a different domain and finally can adapt it off for our own domain. This is transfer learning that can be achieved by pre-trained model like VGG19. We loaded VGG19 through TensorFlow and freeze the convolution block so that we can use it for feature extractor. And we got 93% validation accuracy. Again, we observed the plot for visualization of model's accuracy and loss. It shows us our model is not overfitting as much as basic CNN, but the performance is not really better. In our final model, we will fine-tune the weights of the layers present in the last two blocks of our VGG19 model. Before fine-tuning, we augmented our images. Previously, we have freezed the convolutional layers. Now we have unfreezed the convolutional layer because of dropout layers to avoid overfitting. Now we have 16 trainable layers except 28 layers. We reduce the learning rate here since we don't want to make too large weights updates to the pre-trained layers when fine-tuning. After training the model, we got 26% validation accuracy without overfitting. Here is the plot. Now we will evaluate our model performance using accuracy, F-score, precision and recall. Among the three models, fine-tuning VGG19 shows its superiority. We evaluated confusion matrix for each of the model, where it also proves that our model is better than other two. Thank you.